The Impossible Burger. It is a burger made only of plants, not beef. Taste testers swear that it tastes just the same as a regular Whopper. So what makes it taste so good? And is this the answer that vegan keto people have been waiting for? And is it a healthier alternative to the Whopper? Well, Keith and I have put it to the test. We tested on two different days, eating a Whopper on one day, an Impossible Burger on the other, and testing our blood glucose and ketones. We are going to bring you all of the results in this video. All right, so let's talk first. Is this the dream come true for vegan keto dieters?
Okay, so it is made of vegetable products. So yeah. That part, you know, makes the grade. The problem is that it's also cooked on the same, or flame grilled on the same broiler or whatever that they've got that they cook their beef and their chicken products on. So it is going to have some traces of things.
Yeah, and they're upfront about that. This came in our bag when we went through the drive-through and got the Whoppers. And it says right on here that it is made on the same grill. So if that's a problem for you, you can get it made.
You can request it to be on a different grill.
Yeah.
So that's
good. So does that automatically then make it healthier since it's only from plants?
Yeah. So if you look at the ingredient list of the Impossible Burger, it's got like 21 ingredients. I mean, it's like a paragraph long. If you look at the ingredient list for the patty that's in the real Whopper, it's like one thing. It's 100% beef, right?
Right.
So, you know how we talk about, you know, the longer the list of ingredients are, we think the less healthy something is, because the further away it's getting from its natural state, right?
Yeah, it's not very natural anymore. And one of the biggest components of an Impossible Burger is soy. Soy is very prominent in this, and we're not fans of soy. You have your reasons,
right? So soy contains a lot of phytoestrogens, and you know, as a man, that's a real concern to me. I try and avoid all soy products, you know, completely.
Yeah, and there's a lot of plant foods that have these phytoestrogens. They're like, you know, like a very similar to the estrogen that we hold in our bodies. And in small amounts, we tolerate them just fine. The challenge is that soy is extremely high in phytoestrogens, and soy is in so many of our foods. Try going into any aisle of your grocery store and picking up five items and seeing that they don't have soybean oil in them. Soybean oil is so prominent. So soy has become so prominent. And because of that, it's very genetically modified plant, which takes it even farther away from its original health value, and also subjected to a lot of pesticides. So unless you are eating organic soy in small amounts, I think, you know, relying on soy for your protein choices is a challenge for health.
Right, and that's tough for vegans, right? I mean, that's soy's with the protein content, that seems to be a basis for a lot of vegan stuff.
Yeah.
We're not fans.
Yeah. So and is it keto? Well, first of all, if you eat the entire Whopper, if you watch our video and we decide if it's keto or not, and then you go in and you order a Whopper and eat the bun and
all the
fixins on top, that is not keto, right?
Is not keto.
So, we're talking to the hardcore low carbers and keto people who will go into a fast food restaurant and scrape everything off of their burger.
Right. So is it keto? So the interesting thing with comparing these two patties, right? Mm-hmm. We have one patty made of beef, one patty that's made of the vegetable products, right? Calorically, very close.
Mm-hmm.
They had almost the same amount of protein.
Yeah.
They had almost the same amount of fat, actually, too.
Yeah, the Whopper, I think, had 18 grams in the patty and 14 grams in the Impossible Burger. But the saturated fat was exactly the same, which was really interesting, I thought. 8 grams of saturated fat in both. So if you're going to Burger King in thoughts of getting your saturated fats down by getting the Impossible Burger, that you're not getting that advantage.
Right. The big difference, though, obviously, is that the Impossible Whopper patty had 9 grams of carbs, while the regular Whopper had, of course, zero.
Yeah. So we use that idea that there's carbs here and there's no carbs here to formulate kind of a hypothesis that we wanted to go forth and test our blood glucose and ketones and see just if we could see if anything's happening when we eat these burgers. So our hypothesis was that since the Impossible Burger contains carbohydrates, it will raise our blood glucose and knock us out of ketosis. All right, so if you've been watching our channel, you know oftentimes we will test two different items to see how they affect us. So we followed our same scientific method. We came up with our hypothesis, which I just shared. And we got up bright and early on two different mornings and did not have anything like coffee, supplements. We didn't exercise or anything like that. All we did was we took our blood at 0 minutes and then we ate a burger patty by scraping all of that food off of there. And we ate them. They tasted all right.
Yeah, the interesting thing is that if you read on Impossible Foods site, what they've engineered this burger to taste like beef because they, through their research, they found that heme was the thing that makes beef taste like beef. Now, heme is, if you've heard of hemoglobin, it is that part of the red blood cell with the iron that carries oxygen. And some plants have hemoglobin too. So they were able to come up with a process where they, they extract DNA and they put it through this fermentation process with this genetically engineered yeast, and they come up with this plant-based heme. Now, surprisingly, it tasted relatively the same. I mean, I was okay eating it.
Yeah. Yeah. I wasn't a fan of eating either of them at 6:30 in the morning with nothing else.
Yeah.
But comparatively, if you had all the fixings, all the burgers and all the fixings on it, you probably would not be able to.
You would not know the difference.
Yeah. So taste-wise, I thought they matched up.
Yeah, they were pretty close.
Well. Yep. So we ate the burgers and then we tested our blood again at 30, 60, and 120 minutes. So why don't we quickly go through what our results were?
Quickly? Let's go through these results. Okay. So with the Impossible Burger with Becky, let's start with ketones. She started off at 1.1. At 30 minutes, she was 1.2, 60, 1.3. And at the 2 hour mark, 120 minutes, you were down to 0.7. So you dropped a little bit at that final hour. My ketones, and I started at 0.4. You know, we know the longstanding problem I have of being in ketosis first thing in the morning. At 30 minutes, I had gone down to 0.2. At 60, I was at 0.3. And at 120, I was at 0.2 still. So, you know, my ketones came down, no doubt. Let's take a look at glucose numbers. Interestingly enough, you started at 80. Mm-hmm. You were 80 at each testing point along that morning.
Yeah,
that stayed exactly the same.
Yeah,
that
was, never happened.
I don't think we've ever seen that. So my glucose, I started at 93. At 30 minutes, I was at 95. 60 minutes, I dropped to 83. I thought that was kind of going in the right direction. And at 120 minutes, I was all the way up to 109.
Yeah, and we even retested that test strip because we thought that was a crazy result to get. And it was actually just a couple of points higher.
It was pretty much the same. So my glucose took a pretty big jump there. So we're going to go ahead. We did test the regular Whopper as well just to kind of give us a control and something to compare it to, because we're assuming that, you know, that we know what happens with the regular Whopper, right? So these are the results with the regular Whopper, with the beef patty. Becky's ketones, you started at 2.2, you went to 3.0, and then to 2.8. And at 120 minutes, you ended at 2.6. You actually ended up higher ketones after the 2 hours of eating that burger than you started. Mm-hmm. My ketones, I started at 0.6, which I was pretty happy with. 30 minutes, I was at 0.5, at 60 minutes, 0.2, and 120 minutes, 0.2. So even eating beef with no carbs, I mean, you know, my ketones dropped.
Yeah, and if you've watched our channel, you know there is such a difference between our metabolism, and that is coming up in another video very soon. So just stay tuned to our channel.
We'll
cover that.
Frustrating, you know, at times. So let's go through your glucose numbers. You started at 76, you went to 70, went to 64, and then you ended at 77. You ended at almost the same place you started, with a little bit of movement going lower in the middle there. My glucose numbers, I started at 87. I went up to 101 and then to 102 and then back down to 89. So I too finished pretty close to where I started, but my movement in the middle was up.
Right.
And that's with the beef patty.
Yeah. Well, so what? Let's draw our conclusions here as far as how they affected us in our states of ketosis. For me, the Impossible Burger did not raise my glucose and actually didn't have too much of an impact on my ketones.
It didn't kick you out of ketosis or knock you out of
ketosis. It didn't knock me out of it, right. And the same, I could say the same for the Whopper. So really, my conclusion for me, if we're on a road trip and we have no alternative, but there's a Burger King there, I could walk in, I could grab a Whopper or an Impossible Burger. I could scrape off everything and eat either one and I'd be perfectly fine.
I will have to stay in the car because I can't eat either of these things, well, apparently.
Yeah, so both of them kind of gave you a little bit, at least a temporary bump in glucose and a drop in ketones.
Yeah, and I should say that I did this test. I completely fasted yesterday.
Yeah.
Not even cream in my coffee.
Yeah.
Because I, you know, I want to make sure that I start in a good ketosis level.
Yeah.
And still, you know, yeah. It's just.
And we decided this is a big topic. This is a topic that a lot of people go through. They just have trouble getting into ketosis and staying there. So we are going to cover that in another topic. But as far as an Impossible Burger, taste?
Pretty good.
Sorry. Healthy?
Yeah.
Not as natural as a beef patty. I mean, a beef, you know, because there's 21 ingredients in it.
Right.
Is it going to have an appreciable amount of change in your ketones and glucose? Depends on your metabolism.
Yeah.
So, all right. Well, I hope that was helpful and fun. And hey, thanks so much for watching. Please stay tuned. We will go into ketones and blood glucose and all that good stuff here coming up soon. So,
Maddie.
Hey, honey.